Good morning, Yak. How are you? Oh, I saved the GIF, so I suppose. We can bring that back. Okay. No, there is noise actually. Maybe it's a little quieter than before. Actually, it turns out on that noise generator, you want to use brown noise because, like, white noise has all the different whatever frequencies at the same amplitude, and then pink noise dims some of the higher ones, I think. But then brown noise, I don't know who came up with these names, but apparently brown noise, like, really focuses more on the lower frequencies or whatever, so it makes the higher pitch noise less. And then I even take that and I modify it myself so that the higher pitch is even lower. So that's what we're listening to now. It's a really comforting noise. You know, it's funny. I never like thought about that, Yak. Like, I'm not really familiar with the audio end of things, but I knew about that for visual, like perceived brightness. Yak, exactly. Like the human eye sees the color green really bright and the color blue pretty dark. And so if you have like a pure blue light, the brightness of it will seem darker than green, like than a pure green. And actually, I actually have some code that I wrote here to kind of take care of that. It's not very accurate. Here, where's the new color? New color. Okay. Assign color. Okay, check this out. Okay, so this is a pretty hacky way to do it, but so there's a random hue between 1 and 360. Maybe that should be 0 and 360. I don't know. But random saturation. Then there's a lightness bonus. So sometimes it's brighter or darker. So I can have like a varied, you know, a group of colors, but I don't want it to be too dark. And I don't want it to be too saturated or too desaturated. So, like, there's ranges. But then, if the hue is greater than 50 and less than 190, then it's in, like, the green slash cyan range. And then, so I decrease the brightness. But then if it's in the blue purple range, 210 to 300, then I increase the brightness. And so there's like these cliffs, like cutoffs, you know, like exact number. Like for example, if it was like 209, it would just fall off a cliff here because, you know, it's not like a gradation. But oh yeah, exactly. It's like, see, that's the thing. You can't just use nice round numbers like 0000FF. You can't do that because it's gonna look terrible. Anyway, that's how I handle the color assignment. Obviously, this could be improved. And if I was to improve this, I would have it constantly. I should have it like, it should like spit out an entire like graph of what's possible. And then I could examine it and be like, oh, I should bring up the blue here or whatever, you know. Maybe someday I'll actually put that kind of effort into it. But for now, this works. It's fine. So that's how I do it. But I was actually looking at the update block function, which is, this is going to be used for, there's something called history objects, and it sets some pieces of data, like who did the thing, what is their color, and what turn was it on, and what type was it. But then I take this data, and then I just throw this into the blocks HTML data, element data, whatever. And then inside of this other function called block hover data, I don't need this here, get rid of this. Okay, so in here, if show history, then it starts to grab, it grabs the data from the element history. History is just its own piece of data, and for each piece of the history length, it will append what block type it was, who placed it, what color is their name, show their display name, and then it was caused by, if this was like a collision, it'd be like caused by collision or whatever, and then on turn, and then it gives you the history. So this is a little history thing that I have, but the issue is that it looks so complicated. I don't think it's that complicated. I'm not trying to brag or anything. I'm using some old ways of doing stuff because I'm really comfortable with jQuery and I never learned React or Vue or anything. So I basically just, when I want to modify the client, I just create things called append strings where I just kind of group up what I want to put, and then I can use code, as you can see, to modify whatever gets put, and then I simply append it with jQuery. It's really simple. Yeah. Anyway, fuck, what was I talking about? I feel like I was talking about something. What was I talking about? I don't remember. I don't remember what I was talking about. Oh yeah, I remember now. So part of the issue is that it literally just, what block type was placed, right? But that's not quite right though, because if you place a circle, it shouldn't say you placed like a jump plus. It should say in the history that you used a circle on that. And if you reclaimed something, it should be like reclaimed by, you know? So, I mean, this stores like a blank for reclaim, for example, and I think that mainly what I need to do is, I think what I could do is actually write the history in this function, which is the server side update block. So instead of storing like data about this history object, I think I could literally just store a string to be appended straight from the server while it still knows what the fuck happened up here. Like, was there a mine explosion or a reclaim? I mean, I don't know. There's a lot of ways of doing this. I don't know. I just think that maybe it'd be simpler if I just write the history right here. The new way of writing JavaScript where you set up a function to generate a function and you give it a lambda as a parameter and the whole thing is unreadable. I don't know what you're talking about, actually. See, I've not kept up with new JavaScript. This is like pretty, I mean, I don't know. I feel like my code is basically something you'd see in like 2010 or something. And hyperbole. Okay. Okay, well, I don't really know what you mean, because I don't really keep up with like all the new stuff, so Then there's this thing, show history. By default, show history is true. It's false if it's a source. The reason why is because the way possession works is not coded very accurately, kind of, so it doesn't show it correctly. So it's just like, don't even show who has possession, because you can see it's their base. I mean, I don't know. This is kind of a mess right here. Like, there are pieces of... I'm only concerned with the move history, so, like, X and Y position, that's fine. Block type, that's fine. Although, notice how I modify block type here. If it's a source, then it says player source, and it's the same color as their whatever. It's, like, kind of a special thing. Well, I guess history should be an array full of strings. And then the strings are generated on the server. So like for I equals 0, I is less than history length, I plus plus. I think what I would really want is to actually replace... I think my goal is to replace this. Also, what is happening here? Like, what? Okay. So, I think my goal is to do this. There, that's it. I think that's all I want to do. Nathan, thanks for subscribing. What language is this? This is JavaScript. Hello. Hello. Thanks, Nathan. All right. Okay, so it has history, and then I'm creating something called a history object, and this should actually be like history string. I think my goal here is to do literally just pushing strings into this thing, and the string will be concocted out of this kind of stuff. Now, there's kind of an issue here where I'm actually still setting... I'm still setting some other stuff in this, like, if-else. So I still need to set these along the way as I build the string. Oh, what am I working on today? Well, okay, so what I'm doing today is when you hover over blocks, you get the history, but there's stuff I don't like about it. For example, if you place like an X and then you place like a jump, a circle, and you hover over it, it says X placed by Narcissa on turn 1, jump X placed by Narcissa on turn 2. And I think it should literally say circled by Narcissa on turn 2. Because that's like more accurate to what happens. Because you can place a jump X by itself, and it still says jump X placed. And so when you're reading the history, it doesn't read very well because this is confusing. Another thing that's shitty too is if you reclaim, it says blank placed by Narcissa on turn 4. It should say reclaimed by Narcissa on turn 4. Stuff like that. Like, I just don't like the way it comes out. So, I think what I'm gonna do is create all this history text on the server and then literally just render it how I want it, here, instead of trying to grab these different variables that I'm saving. Just create the string that I want it to be. You haven't played since Mines and Reclaim? Oh, they're really good, actually. I think the game is, like, improved. Well, yak, eventually we should have a replace. Just like replay. Yeah, Yak, did you want to try again, or is it still bottlenecking you? I guess the server's not up right now. Well, it's up, but it's like a practice server, so there's not real games happening. Oh yeah, like, well, it does say stealthy mine placed, but then if you trip the mine, it says blockade placed. Like, that's not what happened. A blockade was not placed. What happened was the mine was tripped. So, and then also, it says blank caused by collision fade on turn 11. That's not too bad, but maybe it could be worded better. Okay. So the first thing it does is, okay, it's a div, then bold what it is. Oh, and then this function readable block name, that should actually end up on the server too. Is that, wait a minute, I think this is only used for this, so I could actually probably just move this directly to the server. Wait, maybe not though, because no, maybe not, actually, no. I feel like I need to duplicate this readable block name function on the server. So I guess I'll do that. It's a little bit irritating, actually. I don't know if I like this so much, but whatever. I didn't want to do that. Nintendo. Hey, thank you, Nintendo. Actually, I have to go to the bathroom. I'm back. Hello. What about like circle though? See, that's a problem. I need to know that. Fuck. Okay, what are all the special things? Circle. Mine explosion. Reclaim. Collision. Or something. I guess if origin equals collision. Things. The problem is circle is not here. Because it takes mine turns into mine explosion, but then place circle. See, this is under a function called validate move, and I think I can maybe transform the circle into actually what it becomes later. So first, go to attempt move, where you can find validate move. Block type. See, now validate move returns like mine explosion as block type. It transforms circles into valid moves. This is actually bad. It should actually keep it as a circle, I think. And then transform circle should be a function, and that should be used inside of update block. So it stores it in temp block, passes that into perform turn. And then inside of perform turn, see, it's valid for the type to be like reclaim. So I can pass in like any string in here and it'll be valid as long as update block handles it. So I think this validate move function what is happening? Oh, God. So this is what was there before. Then there's these functions that are defined, but then it goes to if. So if block type is not undefined, what if the block type is like, reclaim check, wait. Yeah, okay. I actually don't feel like talking right now, so I'm gonna mute myself. I could put on hyphen. Let me get the real hyphen, not the YouTube video, okay? So give me a second, I'll do that. I just like, I don't know, sometimes I'm not talkative and I feel self-conscious. I just wanna like relax. Okay, I'm gonna get hyphen. Okay, so it's on my old hard drive. Hello, my friends. Hello. How are you today? Sub is the same as regular sub, it's not any different. Disconnected. I feel lazy again. I know there's a lot of things to do still, but it's kind of like I just added this. I just made this better, but now I'm like, maybe I want to, I don't know, go for a walk? Alright, I think I'm gonna go then. I might do another dev stream later today. I just think that, I don't know, I made a little milestone just now. And then, feels like I should just maybe give it some hours and go do something else before I jump into, I guess, the next thing will be to put the list of moves in the chat for each turn, so you can just like quick at a glance see if I used both of their jump plus or whatever. But alright, that's all, so I'll see you next time. Thank you and goodbye.